His service throughout the competition has been charismatic, professional, and knowledgeable.
Hi there. You enjoying?
Enjoy. Nice combination of flavours.
Thank you. Yeah, we tried to. It's a traditional street dish, so basically the hot with the cold, the sweet with the spicy, just to kind of ignite all your flavours all the way through the meal.
He's also playing his part in the kitchen, encouraging Minal and giving her customer feedback.
Minal.
Yes.
Table number three. Compliments to the chef. The starters are amazing.
Thank you.
Keep coming.
Thank you.
But just when it's all going so right, dishes get sent to the wrong table. And Bobby's two starters short.
The 7 and 8 starters have been plated to a ready table for starters, which is table number 5. Can I take 2 of these and complete that starter?
A mistake like this can throw a kitchen into chaos.
If they're not clear, they come back down with a tray.
Okay.
And they tell me and I rectify it again.
Okay.
They cannot go to a different fucking table. So when I send 2 chat away on 7 and 2 away on table 8, it's got to go there.
Minal doesn't miss a beat. She just deals with the problem smoothly and efficiently.
I cannot have this mistake starting with the main course.
OK.
Let's go. I need 2 more.
Got a bit of a telling off. Not good. But we've rectified that.
How long for the chat? 5 minutes. Let's go. Hey, we've got 2 to table 1, please. Let's go. Nice and steady. Let's go. Away now. 2, chat. Let's go.
In the first round of the competition, Prashad came up against another exceptional Indian, the brilliant from London. What will front of house manager Dipna and her father Gulu think of their starter?
You had all the other ingredients in it, like the chickpeas, the potatoes, they had the snacky bale and chard sort of mixture.
I really like it. The combination of the sweet and the kind of tangy flavour comes through really nicely.
Now to hear what my experts made of Prashad's starter.
I quite like the adventurous task of trying to put the hot samosa inside the garnish.
Yeah. The joy of Prashad is that they are very comfortable within their own boundaries. And, you know, we've eaten some fantastic food.
I think they could have done a better justice to their cuisine, lots of different tasting like we had up in Bradford.
OK, go, please. Good. Lay down. Well done. Well done, well done, well done.
Starter service is finished. Before they move on to the main course, I need to taste both dishes.
Prashad, chat. Nice. Got that heat. That nice, sweet tamarind flavour. Quite like the hot samosa running through, but it's got that balance between the sweet, savoury and the heat there as well. Very good. Risotto of new potatoes. Only these guys would turn potatoes into granules of rice. It's very rich with the seps. You can only eat 2 or 3 mouthfuls of it, so it's not like a proper risotto. However, very clever. If there's one criticism on that, it's just a touch too salty. 2 very interesting starters. Right now, which one to prefer out of those 2? Well, I'd have to say, Prashad.
Next, will Casimir get out of first gear?
Send some food, will you? Let's go. Unbelievable. Fucking you two, do my fucking head in, I swear to God.
And will Prashad buckle under the pressure? My finalist Casimir, the culinary alchemist from Bristol, and Prashad, the masters of vegetarian Indian cuisine from Bradford, are about to create their main courses, and I'm expecting perfection.
It's getting very tough. Now it's coming the main course.
OK, Casimir, 3 stunning turbot away, chef table, yes?
Yes, chef.
Prashad. 3 stunning bindi, chef table.
Okay.
Looking fantastic, yeah? Really good. Hey, Casimir, a little bit slow. They need to improve their coordination skills rather than sort of trying to cook silently. As one table's going, they should have one working, so there's not that static in between.
At their restaurant in Bristol, brothers John Ray and Peter are always pushing the boundaries with their food, trying to create new and exciting flavour and texture combinations. And their main course tonight, roast turbot with chicken wings and salsify, relies heavily on their favourite cooking technique, sous vide, the water bath.
When you put this in the water bath, none of the flavours are going to be disappearing. They're all going to stay inside it. So it's almost going to be cooking its own juices. And that's the whole benefit of it, because you want to hold in as much flavour as possible.
It's a clever move by the boys, combining their beloved water bath with old-fashioned pan roasting means they'll get the best of both worlds.
Getting it perfection, and that's what we strive for in every single dish we do in Casimir.
heat to it.
It's a daring dish for the final. I've criticised Casimir for overusing their water bath before. And because every plate needs absolute precision, it demands the kind of teamwork they haven't shown yet.
I need to see some form of fucking teamwork going on. Yes, if there's one thing I've got with you guys, it's a stop-start. You've got to get 21st century flow.
Yes, chef.
It's nice to push the boat out, but you've got to get into a flow, yes?
Yes, chef.
We're under a massive amount of pressure today. You know, Gordon wants 110% and he pushes you all the way. Not only does he want speed, some communication, but he wants the dish that's gone out perfect. You know, obviously, you see tonight we've got like 3 people on the chef's table that we've got to please and the rest of the diners. So, absolutely mad experience. Cheval just like over the south side.
Yeah, one there.
Happy?
Yes, chef.
Yep, good. Go, please. Table one. Thank you. Let's go, guys.
But how has the unusual combination of chicken and fish gone down with my diners?
Turbot works excellently with me. I think it's absolutely sound choice that they made. The turbot was perfect. The chicken wings were really good. And the salsify brought it all together. The creaminess in the middle. Again, it's what I expect from Casimir. They're very clever. They know what they're doing. And he was executed really good.
Turbot's a very meaty, robust piece of fish. It doesn't take kindly to being cooked slowly.
No.
Because it sort of almost destroys the texture. Yeah. You want that nice crisp sear on the outside and a little slightly translucent clear in the centre.
My problem, though, is, you know, this obsession with the water bath. It just, for me, you know, I know what I'm like if I stay in a hot water bath for too long, I go rubbery. Yeah.
They put a little bit of rock salt, touch of lemon juice on it, it would have lifted the whole thing.
I think elements on that plate were fantastic from Casimir. I love the roasted salsify. I love the way they used chervil on the plate. I thought that was delicious. It's a fantastic combination. The jus brought the whole thing together, seasoned the whole plate perfectly. Yeah, I thought it was a good effort.
Yep. You know they can cook. The salsify puree was delicious. The roasted salsify, we so often experience when they're hard. You know, they did it perfectly.
And they're being really, really inventive. They're coming up with new dishes specifically for this competition. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, I've got to admire that.
Yeah, the ballsiness.
Yeah, it's great.
That's ready, Pete. It's just waiting on the salsify for me. Next time you get
chef. That turbot looks fantastic, guys. Yeah, keep it going, yes?
Yes, chef. We're working on it, chef.
Whilst the boys' daring dish has really impressed, upstairs their parents,
Susie,
are clearly feeling the strain.
Are on the pillow for the other lady.
Yeah, OK, Packer.
On the right.
All right. Stop going on, Packer.
I'm feeling a little bit under pressure, a little bit. This is Gordon Ramsay's best restaurant. You want to do your best.
Prashad have chosen to cook a tried and tested dish.
It's not hard, because every day we're making this.
For their main course, they're cooking okra curry served with a Gujarati dal soup, rice and raita. It's a popular dish with their loyal customers in Bradford.
What we chosen the meal is a traditionally Gujarati meal. Okra is very popular. My customer love the okra. Indra Prasad is the first time selling this.
The key to Prashad's success is the way they transform traditional family recipes with their unique balance of tastes, textures and spices.
In India, every 2 days, we eat in okra and the dal and the rice. This is a very balanced meal because okra, it's not too spicy curry. That lentil soup, it's very creamy and rich.
How long for the five, please? 10 minutes, thank you. Let's go.
La bina kaya lem.
Arya.
Lakho kai ni.
But as service ramps up, even Prashad's calm facade is beginning to crack. Food has been spilled, and they're starting to get in each other's way.
Excuse me, please. Oof!
Minal, you got spare?
Yeah, I got plenty.
Chala, we card. Put on it and look good luck. You want my vichar, sir?
Uma.
Yep, away now.
But Bobby's back on form and holding it together in the dining room.
We're in the flow now. The food's coming up, it's good and it's been received well.
Have Prashad done enough to convince my diners their main course is worthy of the final?
Much better presentation. Yes.
Much better presentation.
It's contemporary and it's modern, which I like.
I've never thought I liked okra, but actually, this okra is delicious, isn't it?
But will it be enough to impress my demanding experts?
Prashad's, Bindi, how was that okra?
The tastes were really intense, very powerful. And really expertly done, and done with ease. You can tell the person that cooked that, they just do it with ease. It comes, you know, it's very passionate, and it's really skillful. Very impressed.
Very hard to get okra tasting delicious.
But it was good, the okra was great. I just think they could have lifted everything slightly one level up.
Prashad's
Okay, Kaushik, me now.
Yes.
Main course is all gone. Good job. Great job, yes? Clear down, get ready for desserts, yes?
After judging the starters, I put Prashad ahead on the night, but has Casimir's main pulled it back.
Turbot cooked. Water bar. You all right? Delicious. There's elements of maturity across this plate because they're listening. They're using the techniques they're akin to with their slow cooking water bath, but they're bringing in, you know, the roasting of the turbot at the end. Very clever. But the chicken and the turbot work, and there's harmony there. Really good. Prashad.
Wow.
It's delicious. Just, you want more. Okra's delicious. Got a little crunch. It really is vibrant. And a nice blend of spices. Really nice. What they have done across this main course is they've refined it. They've really brought Gujarati to Knightsbridge. Both teams have really taken on board my constructive prison and today delivered two fantastic main courses. Which one would I prefer? Right now, both of them.
Next, there's everything to play for with the desserts.
Last course, yeah, come on.
Yes, chef.
Make it work, yes?
I don't know if we won. It's too close to call again. It's too close.
We're going to win, definitely. We are.
Then I'll be making one of the hardest decisions I've ever had to make.
The winner and a mighty congratulations goes to...
Who will be crowned my best restaurant? At the end of tonight's dinner, I'll be choosing the winner of my best restaurant. I'll make my decision on their menus and how they perform throughout the competition. I have Prashad ahead in the starter and both restaurants neck and neck in the main course. The dessert will be the decider.
Table four, please. All right, guys, last course, yeah? Minal, Kaushi, last course, keep it going, yes?
Yes.
Okay, end on a high, yes?
From their small deli attached to the restaurant in Bradford, Prashad serve a huge range of deliciously sweet Indian desserts, which Kaushi and Manal are attempting to modernise for their final dish.
We're making homemade Indian sweets. This sweet is a delicate, same time is a rich also.
All three of their desserts use a combination of ghee, flour and jaggery, an unrefined cane sugar that is extremely sweet but extremely popular in traditional Indian desserts.
Gordon will definitely like it. He liked my food, so I'm sure he liked this one also.
The first sweet is a square of Gaur Laddu. Then a Gaur Papdi, delicate sesame balls. And finally, Magaj, a cardamom spice sweet. Each will be served with a glass of ginger tea.
It's a nice way of finishing a classic main course. What I like about it is quite modern. And they've sort of taken a leaf out of Casimir's book there and thought, well, they're doing that with Italian food. I can do that with vegetarian Indian food. Clever.